Hey guys, today I want to talk about coding on a budget. If you're familiar with my other videos, I talk about why I think you should go to a coding bootcamp school in 2020. I realized after I made that video that not everyone's situation is going to be the same, and some people can't afford a coding bootcamp school. So I wanted to find resources that are free or relatively affordable for you to start your coding journey and potentially land that junior developer job. I broke this down into three sections. The first is the learning and the actual resources. The second is how to find mentorship. And third is the interview prep. In the first section of learning and resources, you might be familiar with this website already, but if you're not, I highly recommend freecodecamp.org. In freecodecamp.org, you're going to learn to code, build projects, and earn certifications. The certifications are narrowed down in the website below by responsive web design, JavaScript, front-end libraries, some APIs, and data visualization. This is a very comprehensive list, and as someone that's just starting off, this might feel very overwhelming. So what I would suggest in terms of an order of learning is doing the responsive web design certification first. The second would be the JavaScript algorithms and data structures. Third would be the front-end library certification. I would skip the data visualization certification and then work on the API and microservices certification. The reason why I suggest these four and kind of skip these other two is because as a developer, the data visualization part is very niche, and I don't think every developer needs to know how D3 really works. So let's skip that one for now. And to see an example of how these lessons are laid out, I can open up the responsive web design certification, open up the basic HTML, and it says say hello to HTML elements, and that's right here. In the free code camp tutorials, they'll give you a prompt on the left-hand side to solve a problem or do a project. You have the ability to run the tests, and you'll get some kind of feedback saying that your tests did not work properly, and you could reset the code. And lastly, you could get help. You could get a help by getting a hint, watching a video, or asking for help. Clicking asking for help will open up one of these forums here. And Free Code Camp does a very good job of categorizing certain topics, whether it be the resource help for the lessons itself, career feedback, just words of encouragement, a lot of things that aspiring developers need when starting off. Contrary to popular belief, being a developer is not just sitting in a cubicle or sitting in a corner just working by yourself. You need those words of encouragement, communication, and just getting that feedback from people that are in the same situation as you is always helpful. In terms of the lessons themselves, what you can do is attack these challenges. And in this case, I need to type in hello world. You run your tests and you'll get a feedback saying you completed your task. I recommend you to sign in to save your progress so you can track how you go from beginning to the end. So based on these examples, I highly recommend going through these specific certification routes, the responsive web design, the JavaScript algorithms, the front-end library certs, and the API and microservices. The next thing I would do after Free Code Camp is go on Udemy.com. Udemy.com is a website where teachers can create courses ranging from all various subjects. Specific to us, we want to learn JavaScript and some front-end framework. And the two classes I recommend are the ES6 JavaScript, The Complete Developer's Guide by Steven Greider. And the second one is the Modern React with Redux, also by Steven Greider. His lessons are very comprehensive and very easy to digest. And I think it would really be helpful for you to, number one, get some fundamentals from the Free Code Camp first. And then when you transition into the Udemy courses, they're gonna be a little bit more easier to understand. Don't worry about these $179 prices. I highly recommend you to wait it out because Udemy has a tendency to have these promotions, whether it be Christmas promotions or Valentine's Day promotions. Any promotions usually do show up, and the courses should range between $10 to $15. So don't pay for the $79.99 or the $179.99. It'll definitely get lower, so just wait it out until the next promotion. Now that we've got the resources and learning out of the way, the second thing I want to talk about is mentorship. If you're going to be learning how to code on your own, mentorship is a must. And I recommend this website called codingcoach.io. Coding Coach is a website that connects developers with mentors worldwide. You can click on the mentors here, and you can see a list of mentors with their specialties. For example, Matthew R. Downey has a specialty in Udemy, backend, algorithms, game dev, and C#. Unfortunately, he's not taking any mentors right now, but once you create an account, you can apply and see if your mentorship-mentee relationship can be built. Since this is free, I don't see why anyone would not want to do this. This is a great opportunity on both ends as a mentor to provide knowledge and help to an aspiring developer. And for the aspiring developer, it's good to get feedback on the process and the struggles of what it takes to become a software engineer. To me, having that kind of resource is amazing, and it's free. So why not take that opportunity? So now that we've got the resource learning knocked out, we got the mentorship knocked down, what's the third category? Interview prep. We're gonna go back to the free Codecamp org, scroll down a little bit, and you'll see the coding interview prep, thousands of hours of challenges. Unfortunately, in this one, you're just gonna have to drill them out, and you're gonna have to do some algorithms, data structures, take-home projects, Rosetta code, Project Euler. I would not overwhelm myself and try to do all of these problems, but if you can do maybe one a day or just a few a day, I would recommend going that path. There's no point, in my opinion, of just doing it for the sake of doing it and then you get 9 out of 9 or 46 out of 46. Do it with a sense of trying to understand how to solve this problem so that if you get that problem in an interview, you'll know how to do it rather than just memorizing it. If you're willing to spend a little bit of money on a course, I would recommend, once again, Steven Greider's course on the Coding Interview Bootcamp, Algorithms and Data Structures. Wait for a lower price. It should be around $10 to $15 during promotions. He does a great job of doing these algorithm questions in a very, very understandable way. For example, palindromes. He'll give you the question of palindromes. He'll give you a solution and an alternate solution. On top of these courses, there are tests around the code itself to make sure that you're solving the algorithm properly. And I just can't say enough about his courses because they're very helpful. They're very easy to digest, and it really helps you feel like you're making progress in your coding journey. So with the three sections checked off of resources and projects, mentorship, and interview prep, I would go in this order of my learning process. Do the responsive web design certification first. Second would be the JavaScript algorithm and data structures. Third would be the front-end libraries. Fourth would be the API and microservices cert. After that, I would move over to the Udemy courses and do the ES6 JavaScript and the Modern React with Redux course. Once you've completed all those courses, I will start moving over to the interview prep by using both the free Codecamp and the Udemy Coding Interview Bootcamp Algorithms course. I hope that this layout gave you some kind of structure and plan for you to learn how to code on a budget. If you like content like this, please give me a like and subscribe. It really helps out the channel. We're slowly growing this channel one subscriber at a time, so I appreciate everyone that leaves a comment and gives me feedback on my videos. With that being said, I hope that you can start your coding journey by starting off with the free codecamp.org. If you have any questions again, please let me know. Until then, Techrally out. Scar!
Yeah. Okay, now good. Now look, that's good. We'll be on the track.
ZC on the track, boy.